or what was it that inspired you to want to become an actress?
I think it was having amazing teachers that really told me that there were no limits, and if I wanted to do something and I was that driven and wanted to put in the hard work, I could do it. So it's those guiding posts that you have in your life, whether it's something like this, a teacher, a friend that encourages you to try something new. It's things like this that really inspire you, I think, and support you.
Talking about working hard, what have you got coming up yourself in 2017?
So we've got Kingsman 2 that should be coming out later in the year. Are you?
We're all excited about that. What, if anything, can you tell us about what fans should expect from that?
I have got my lips so firmly sealed, I will be in such trouble with Matthew Vaughan. But yeah, expect a lot more of the same, but bigger and definitely bolder.
The first film was obviously a huge hit. Why do you think that is? Why do you think people responded so much to the unique tone, I guess, of the first film?
I think Matthew's very good at having a sense of what the audience wants. He does this incredible kind of maverick film with such fun, and it's always with that. It's like the joy of filmmaking. He really captures the audience and takes you along, and it's a story like there wasn't around at that time. And I don't know, someone like Taron, who's, you know, so fun and charismatic, really takes you on that journey. And then you have someone like Colin and Sam. It's like a great cast telling a really fun story.
And obviously the cast was such a big part of the first film. Is that why you think it was so important to get Colin back in particular? Because I think, I mean, fans thought we'd seen the last of him, but it's so nice to see those glasses and know that he is back.
I mean, Colin is a true Kingsman. Yeah, him and Mark, they should definitely do that professionally. They're so good at it. And seeing Colin in a suit, everyone needs to see that again. So,
I know we're only two films in, but there's already a sense that it could be a real-life Bond in the sense that it really could run. Do you think that's something that could happen? Do you think it's a story that could keep going in the same way that Bond has for all those years?
I think the truth is, with Matthew Vaughan, anything could happen. So I'm waiting to hear as much as you guys.
Obviously, we're here celebrating these great young filmmakers, and you're talking about Matthew being a special filmmaker. What makes someone like Matthew a great director? What is the essence of a good director?
I don't think there's one unique thing, but definitely attention to detail Matthew has, and it's that real motivation, which is what all of these young guys here have today, that real drive and ambition to make something and enjoy it. Like, it shouldn't be a chore. It's like, it's supposed to be fun. And all of the work that I've seen today definitely shows that.
On a slightly serious note, obviously there's always a big debate about particularly gender diversity and how many opportunities there are for women, particularly behind the camera. As a young actress and someone who's just starting out in the industry yourself, is that something that you're very aware of and have feelings about one way or the other?
Yeah, I mean, I have a lot of feelings about it. The job I've just finished in New York is a job for Netflix, a new Netflix original series, written by Lisa Rubin, directed by Sam Taylor Johnson, produced by Liza Chasen, all of these amazing women behind it. It's me, Naomi, Lucy Boynton, like a great cast of females. So I think, you know, we're definitely making steps in the right direction. And hopefully Eleanor can wave the flag for us in the future too.